What ho! My name is Tucker Hyatt. I'm a physics teacher with 35 years of experience, and I'm also the executive director of Wonderfest, the San Francisco Bay Area beacon of science. Welcome to Radical Physics. What's radical, besides our location here in the gamma sector of the Milky Way, I'll explain quite soon. But first, we better look at what physics is and why it's worth understanding. Physics is the study of nature. Physics encompasses our deepest scientific understanding of the universe and everything in it. The word physics comes from the ancient Greek root meaning nature, but not just nature as trees and bugs, sunsets and spacescapes. Rather, nature au naturel, naked nature. Nature laid bare so that we can see what is really going on underneath. Albert Einstein famously said, "I want to know God's thoughts." Whether we profess to know anything about God or not, we can understand what Einstein was after. Einstein was a physicist. He wanted to know the deepest laws of nature. He wanted to understand the relatively few basic mechanisms that seem to underlie everything that happens. Astronomer Carl Sagan said it differently. In his Cosmos video series, Sagan asked us to join him in exploring the awesome machinery of nature. This was the physicist in Sagan talking. Speaking of machinery, let me show you something. This is a MOVA globe. This beautiful piece of art, this lovely machine, turns smoothly and continuously, overcoming friction, without any obvious source of energy. There really are no wires attached. There is no battery included here anywhere. We will come back to the MOVA globe later. And what about this? This gorgeous orchid is a biological machine. Calling it a machine doesn't diminish its beauty. In fact, it may enhance our sense of wonder, and it may urge us to understand how the orchid, for example, reflects electromagnetic waves, and how it grows upward, fighting gravity at every moment. And there is a third machine here in the gamma sector, namely your instructor. What kind of machine am I? In particular, up here, what are the mechanisms of thought? What is the nature of mind? It seems incongruous to mention mechanism in the same breath with the word nature. But that's because we are unfamiliar with physics, the deep study of nature. Only 1/3 of US students ever take a year-long course in physics. What effect does this have on the American ability to understand mechanisms and to raise the next generation of scientists and engineers? Consider this layers of scientific understanding poster. Principal subjects of science appear here as geological strata. Psychology rests atop biology because, as far as we know, psychological events are a special class of biological events. So psychology is grounded in biology. Biology, in turn, is grounded in chemistry, and chemistry is grounded in physics. Finally, all these branches of science rest on the deepest stratum, philosophy, the philosophy of science. Each major subject reveals three substrata that describe structures of differing scale, from large to small. Each such structure refers laterally to a crucial scientific theory that underlies our understanding of the universe at that level. Physics is the fundamental science. It underlies all the other sciences. In this poster, the substrata of physics are universe, world, and quantum. And the corresponding scientific theories are general relativity, classical mechanics, and quantum mechanics. There's that word again, mechanism, in mechanics. Classical mechanics concerns mechanisms of the everyday world, from planets to people to protoplasm. Quantum mechanics concerns the mechanisms of the microworld. A quantum is just something that's very small, perhaps ultimately small, a tiniest piece of reality that behaves very strangely from our macroscopic point of view. Both classical and quantum mechanics are necessary to understand how the MOVA globe works, and both mechanics are necessary to understand an orchid too. And as far as we know, both are necessary for a complete understanding of a brain. A complete understanding of mind? Well, not yet, but perhaps someday. The title of this video series is Radical Physics. The word radical refers to the root of something, to its fundamentals. A political radical, for example, literally means a person who pays attention to the root principles of a political movement. In this sense, all physics is radical, fundamental, and the name radical physics is just a reminder of essence. It's like amazing in Amazing Grace, or damn in Damn Yankees. Of course, radical has taken on a somewhat different meaning. More often today, it means extreme. As physics presentations go, radical physics is extreme. It's an outlier for being novel in format and even in content. Speaking of format, the online structure of radical physics lives up to its rootsy name. By making generous use of YouTube's annotation function, the radical physics story grows and spreads like a root. Physics tendrils extend through the soil of knowledge, the layers of scientific understanding. The taproot of radical physics, however, runs right through the traditional heart of physics. We will investigate matter and motion, force and energy, sound and light, heat and electricity, waves and particles, entropy and information, and so on. We will study everything our senses sense and how they do it. We will look at physics in popular culture, particularly poking fun at bad physics in the movies. And we will understand remarkable inventions that physics has made possible. After all, physics is the root of virtually all engineering. Radical physics will encourage you to do simple experiments. And when home equipment is insufficient, radical physics will direct you to rich online demonstrations. Also, radical physics will teach how to solve problems. You will learn a systematic approach to problem solving that is helpful in subjects beyond physics, even improving critical thinking skills necessary in everyday life. I began this introduction by saying that physics is the study of nature. In fact, a century or so ago, the field of physics was known as natural philosophy. Even today, physicists sometimes say that they study the rules of existence. If you want to know whether something is real or not, whether it can really exist in this universe, it couldn't hurt to ask a physicist. Physics is full of insight and understanding, but maybe even better, physics is full of surprises. Common sense is gloriously wrong about so many things. Take a look at this simple electric lamp. I think you can see that this ordinary desk lamp here is plugged into an extension cord that in turn is plugged into a nearby wall and power outlet here in the gamma sector of the Milky Way. But this is an energized extension cord, you can tell, because when I turn the desk lamp on, you notice that the bulb does indeed go on. And when I unplug the desk lamp, no tricks here, the extension cord is still energized. We say that it's a live wire, or an electrician might say that at least one of those two holes in the extension cord here in the plug is hot. So if I'm dumb enough to stick this bent open paper clip into either one of those two holes, I might be in for a rude surprise. Now I am going to do it, but I urge you not to do it. Do not do this unless you know more about electricity, which you will learn soon enough here in radical physics. But if I take this open paperclip and stick it into the slot, I feel nothing. Let me try the other hole. No, nothing. I feel nothing. And this is good old US of A, 120 volts AC. There is something here, clearly, that we don't understand very well. We being most folks who have a common sense understanding of electricity. When we see that we are wrong about simple matters like electric lamps and shocks, our minds are open to being right about many things that were taken for granted. We learn to be skeptics who revel in real knowledge while appreciating, maybe even loving, the truly deep mysteries of the world, some of which we'll get to quite soon in radical physics. The time is right for my favorite Albert Einstein quotation. Here is how Big Al, Time Magazine's Person of the Century for the 20th century, considered his deepest insight. The deepest insight of Albert Einstein. This had better be good. Big Al said, "One thing I have learned in a long life, that all our science measured against reality is primitive and childlike. And yet it is the most precious thing we have." The most precious thing. Each person gets to experience the power and delight of introductory physics only once in a lifetime. Whether you're young or old, whether you are exploring on your own or enrolled in a formal class, I envy your position at the threshold of physics. Prepare to be stunned by the awesome machinery of nature.
When you understand the laws of physics, Penny, anything is possible.